Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, everyone. Good morning. Well, you know what my declaration is? My declaration is I win. I win. I walk in newness of life. What about you today? I walk in newness of life. That is our declaration. That is what we are standing on, that we are new creatures in Christ. And we win. We walk in newness of life. Welcome to this morning's broadcast. Thank you for taking time out of your schedule to join me this morning as we are encouraging our brothers and sisters to win. Walk in newness. Walk in newness of life. Amen. That's what Jesus went to the cross for, that we might walk in the newness of life, that we might live eternally with him forever and ever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. To the natural mind, no, it doesn't seem like something that is possible, but to the spiritual mind, to him that is spiritual, all things are spiritual. To him who is carnal, all things are carnal. But we want to be spiritually minded this morning because the Bible tells us to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Amen, amen, amen. Thank God for his word. Good morning to my husband, Bishop Gerald Scott, who has just joined us. And we just want to go before the Lord in prayer this morning. And God is good. Thank him for waking us up for another day. Amen. He is awesome in all his ways. Amen. 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 Father, we just come before you, thanking you for another day. We bless your name, O God, for you are worthy. You are worthy, O God. Father, we have not seen you with our natural eyes, but we know that you are real. And we thank you for being real. We thank you for being real to us. Father, we just glorify you on this morning. We give you praise and honor. Thank you for waking us up today. Thank you for saving us, Lord God. Thank you for delivering us from those things that we've been delivered from. Thank you, Lord God, for helping us in our time of need. Thank you, God, for being our strength when we've been weak, Lord God. Thank you for being our help in times of trouble. Thank you, Lord God, hallelujah, that even when we didn't know we needed you, you were there for us, Lord, and you blessed us and you kept us, Lord. We thank you today. Father, we thank you for newness of life, oh God. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for newness of life. We thank you today for Jesus. We thank you, hallelujah, for without Jesus, we would not be walking in newness of life. Lord, help us today, Lord, to gain understanding from your word as to what you want us to know. Help us, Lord God, that we will hear with our spiritual ears what your spirit is saying unto us on today, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we just rebuke and cast aside all preconceived ideas, Lord God. We cast it aside, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. And we just say thank you, Lord, for your word. We thank you, Father, for your word. Your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path, Lord God. Hide your word in our hearts, Lord God. We will hide your words in our hearts so we won't sin against you, oh God. We thank you today, Lord God. Bless our nation, oh God. Bless this nation, oh God, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Father. We lift up the President Trump to you, Lord God, and we ask, oh God, that you will send this man godly advisors. Doesn't matter who he's already appointed, God, but you can do all things. And we ask you to send him godly advisors and that he will hear these godly advisors, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we just say thank you, oh God. We thank you and we praise you and give you glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 I've been up since about three something today. And for some reason, I've just been having tears, and I don't know what the tears are for. I'm not sad. I'm nothing, you know, out of the ordinary. I'm still sitting here. But for some reason, it's just been tears. They just been coming. And my husband is too funny. I believe that we need to pray more fervently for our country, for our nation. There's a lot of things being said about our country right now and about our current president, Donald J. Trump. But I believe we need to pray. We just need to pray. We need to pray and keep praying and keep praying. And whatever the Lord gives you to pray, that's what you pray. No matter what man says, whatever God says for you to pray is what I want you to pray and is what I will be praying too. So we come to you this morning with our broadcast, Win. I Win. I win. And I love this I win. I love the fact that God has given me this I win. And it's I walk in newness. This is not something that we're standing in as far as being arrogant or, you know, proud or something like that. But I am proud to be walking in the newness of life. Why? Because there's something to be proud about. There's something to be happy about that we walk in the newness of life. And if you will go to your foundations, our foundation scripture in Romans chapter 6, verse 4, and it says, therefore, we are buried with him by baptism unto death, that like as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life. Now, once we become born again, we become dead to sin. We're no longer dead in sin. We're no longer dead in sin. We're alive unto God now. We're dead to sin. So when sin comes knocking at our door, we should tell that sin we're dead to it. If adultery comes to your door, I'm dead to that. If fornication comes to your door, I'm dead to that. That should be a declaration when these things come to you. And we're going to go over to our scripture, our real foundational scripture, which is in Galatians 5, 17 to 21. And it says in 17, for the flesh lusts against the spirit. And my husband gave a illustration last week about the flesh lusting against the spirit and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary the one to the other, so that you cannot do the things that you would. The flesh and the spirit are always fighting. Why? Because the flesh has been taught, has been something that we've been doing since birth, walking in the flesh, because we didn't know any different. But when we become renewed, when we become born again, our spirit man awakens and we become renewed. Our spirit man, we're born again. We're made new. We're born again. Nicodemus said, can we enter the second time into our mother's womb and be born? And I say this all the time. When I first read that, I was like, what's up with Nikki? Why are you trying to be smart? Nicodemus trying to be smart. He know you can't go back in your mother's womb and be born again. But he wasn't trying to be smart. He was really asking because he didn't have knowledge. And Jesus said, you must be born of the water and of the spirit. And he really, when Jesus explained it to him, he told him, you must be born again. You must be born again. Your spirit man must be born again. You have, when we become born again, we have to change our minds. We have to change our thinking. We have to be renewed in the spirit of our mind, like it says in Romans 12. We have to be renewed in the spirit of our mind. We have to, something that we have to actively do. And one thing that I notice is that when once we begin, once we get born again, once we make that confession of faith that we accept Christ as our Lord and our Savior, once we do that and we think that, oh, that's all we have to do. Well, when you accept Christ Jesus as your Lord and Savior, when we do that, the moment of conversion, that's great. We are new creatures in Christ Jesus, but there's things that we have to do to make sure that we mature in the Lord so that we can, when our flesh is lusting against the spirit and the spirit against the flesh, the spirit man can win, because whatever you feed is what's going to live. Whatever you feed is what's going to live. And maybe you should write that down, that whatever we feed is what's going to live. If we feed our flesh, fleshly things every day, and we don't do anything in the spirit, then our flesh man, our natural man, our carnal man is what's going to rule us. Now, our spirit man can't rule us because our spirit man is malnourished, is malnutrition, because we're not feeding our spirit man. So what we must learn to do is begin to feed our spirit man so that we can mature in the things of God, so we can mature in the spirit. We're not supposed to stay babes in Christ. There are people that have made the confession of faith, that have made the confession that Jesus is Lord. They made this confession years ago, and they're still walking as babes. And Jesus doesn't want us to walk as babes. He wants us to mature in the Lord. He wants us to mature in him. Now, this illustration just came to my mind about a set of twins. You can have a set of twins, and they can be identical twins, okay? But if you feed one and you don't feed the other one, somebody's going to be malnourished. The one that you don't feed is going to be malnourished, while the one you feed is going to prosper and is going to flourish. So then you have these twins, and somebody might say, well, why is this twin so thin and so small, and this twin is so big? And then you'll say, well, I feed this one, but I don't feed that one. And that's the same thing in the spirit, our spirit man versus our flesh. Which one are you going to feed? Are you going to feed your natural man by doing the things that the natural man does? Or are you going to feed your spirit man by doing the things that the Spirit of God wants us to do? We must be transformed. We must be transformed in the renewing of our minds. We must be transformed in the renewing of our minds. We must have a different mindset about the things that we consider. When we become born again, please understand this. When we become born again, there is still things that we have to do. There are still things that we must do. We must actively take part. We must actively take part in our maturity in the Lord. We must actively take part in our spirit man growing. But we can't do that if we're not feeding our spirit man. We must feed our spirit man with the Word of God. You can't feed your spirit man with carnal things. It's not going to work. If we are carnal, we cannot please God, because the Bible says, then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. That's why we must be in Christ. The Bible says if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. There's many people walking around trying to be a new creature, but not in Christ. Good morning, Shirley, his baby girl, Williams. Good morning, see the vision, 2918. God bless you. And we must make sure that we take an active part in feeding our spirit. Don't depend on your pastor to feed your spirit. Don't depend on the evangelist to feed your spirit. That's something that you have to do. Pick up your Bible, pick up your laptop, pick up your tablet, whatever means you use to study the Bible, get it and actively study the Bible. I didn't say read the Bible, study the Bible. We have to study, the Bible says, to show ourselves approved unto God, a workman that needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word truth. But if we don't get in the Word, we can't rightly divide the truth. If we don't get in the Word, we will be workmen that are ashamed. Because why? We haven't studied to show ourselves approved unto God. Unto God. See, this is something that we have to make sure that we truly understand, is that we feed our spirit man. How do we do that? We get the Word of God. See, some of us are still walking in the works of our flesh, and they are manifest. The Bible says the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these. They're manifest. That means that they're being seen. You're operating in them, so this is what you're doing. They're being seen. They're manifest. Something that is manifest is no longer hidden. Something that is manifest is no longer hidden. So it says the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these. Okay, adultery. Everybody should know what adultery means. But like I said last week, we're going to get our little dictionaries out and we're going to study what these words mean, because sometimes people, we read things and we don't really know what we are reading. We don't get an understanding of what it is we're reading, but we read it out of habit instead of studying. Does anybody know what the difference of reading and studying is? Let me just ask you that right quick. If you know the difference, put it in the chat right there and let me know what the difference of between reading the Bible and studying the Bible. There's a difference, let me tell you, because you can read anything. You could just read it and say, oh yeah, well, the flesh lusts against the spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary the one to the other, so that you cannot do the things that you would. Okay, so I read that. What does it mean? What does that mean? So now I have to study it. Now I have to get my Bible dictionary. I have to get out, you know, my tools, my spiritual tools that I need. And I need to say, now this says the flesh lusts against the spirit. Let me see what that means. And the spirit against the flesh. Let me find some more scripture that agrees with this scripture. Let me find out what all of this stuff means. And this is something that you have to do. We wait for God to do this thing by osmosis. We may wait for God to do this thing like he's Houdini. Like he's just going to take the word and abracadabra. Now, because you made the confession of faith, now you know everything that needs to be known. And that's not the truth. We have to take this Bible and we have to study this thing. We have to dissect it. And not dissect it in the terms of you trying to find out, oh, the Bible is false, because you know that movement is going around right now. But take this word and dissect it so that you can, your spirit man, you can get an understanding of what's going on. The Bible says the natural man receiveth not the things of God. The natural man doesn't receive the things of God, but it's our spirit man. So we begin to get in the spirit. And before you go into Bible study, how about you pray? Pray before you go into Bible study. Say, God, I want your understanding. I want to know what you want me to know. I want an understanding of your word. I'm coming into this Bible study. Not Bible reading, but I'm coming to this Bible study, Lord God, so that I can get an understanding of what it is that you're saying to me. You know, there are a lot of applications out there for Bible reading, but we need to have Bible study so that we can get an understanding of the things of God. Now, it says in Galatians 5, we went over verse 17 already. Verse 18 says, but if you are led, if you be led of the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now, the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: and adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness. You notice that these all are in the same sentence. They're in the same group. Adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness. All these things have to do with what we're doing to our bodies. All these things have to do with what we are doing and how we are treating our bodies. Adultery is having sex with somebody who is married, or if you're married and you're having sex outside of your marriage, okay? We know what that is. Some of us act like we don't know what adultery is, but we know what adultery is. And if we are committing adultery, we need to repent. We need to go to God, and we need to commit ourselves back to God, and we need to turn our bodies over to God. And like the Bible tells us, to present our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. But nowadays, you know, we have this movement like it was in the 60s, you know, free sex, just have sex with whomever you want to have sex with, whenever you want to have sex with them. It doesn't matter, because God created sex, and that's what he wanted us to do. Well, God created that union, and that's what people always go over. When God created man, he created that woman for him. He created that woman for Adam, and they two came together, and that's how they started having children. It was Adam and Eve. There was no other Eve there for him. There was no other Adam there for her. It was just him and her, and they came together, and when they did, she became with child, okay? So there was no, God didn't create other people so that Adam can go out there and start messing around with other women, and God didn't create another man for Eve to go out there and start messing around with other men. So let's get that straight. That's from the beginning, okay? So God did create us to come together for sexual activity, but he created man and woman, husband and wife. So if you're married and you're out there having sex with somebody else, somebody that is not your spouse, you need to check that. You need to check yourself. As a Christian, I'm speaking to the body of Christ. I'm not speaking to the world. I'm speaking to the body of Christ, because the world, they cannot receive the things of God. And the things of God don't pertain to the world. It pertains to us as born-again believers, as Christians, as followers of Christ. This word pertains to us, not the world. See, we get it twisted sometimes, and we condemn the world for what they're doing, but they're doing what they're supposed to do. They're following their father, who is the devil. The Bible says, your father, the devil. So if it's not of God, who is it of? So we're not concerned about that right now, but we're talking about the body of Christ. It's time for the body of Christ to mature in the things of God, in the spiritual things, and we must get a hold of adultery. If you are married and you're sleeping with someone who is not your spouse, that is adultery. If you are not married and you're sleeping with someone who is married, you're causing that person to commit adultery. You're in fornication. Fornication and adultery, we shouldn't be doing that. We shouldn't be doing it. If we're not married, we should preserve our bodies for those who we're going to be married to, okay? And that might be something hard to say. Somebody said, well, you're married. You get to get the benefits of marriage, or whatever the case is. Listen, if you want to abstain, you can. If you want to present your body as a living sacrifice and wait for your spouse, you can do that. But you have to want to do it, and you have to feed your spirit man so that you can get there. Okay, now we said we're going to go over definitions, and we have to go over these definitions. So this study is not going to be a short study, but it's going to be something that we have to go through very slowly. The New Testament fornication, in the New Testament, the word fornication comes from what? pornea. Okay, that's where we get pornography from. Okay, so, and it says, which includes adultery and incest. Pornea comes from another Greek word that also includes indulging in any kind of unlawful lust, which would include homosexuality. Now, I know people will throw stones at me for saying this, for talking about this, but this is a part of presenting our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. It talks about homosexuality, and this is something that's very prevalent in the body of Christ today, is that, you know, we have first men, first gentlemen in the body of Christ. We have men marrying men in the body of Christ. We have women marrying women in the body of Christ. We have people who are coming against other Christians for speaking against homosexuality. But what I'm here to say this is that if we're going to speak about homosexuality, we need to speak against adultery and fornication as well. We need to speak against all types of sexual sin as well. There should be no adultery or fornication or homosexuality, which, I mean, it doesn't matter if you're sleeping with the same sex or not. If you're not married, we shouldn't be doing that. But if we are in same-sex relationships, that is not of God. God didn't create that. God did not create that, but we have to be spiritually minded to understand that. And some people just won't get it, and they'll say, well, God ordained this. God did not ordain that. God ordained man and woman. But I'm not here to pounce on homosexuality. We are here to talk about sin, fornication, adultery, and lasciviousness, uncleanness. All of these things are what we're here to talk about. So we're not here to harp on just one thing. We're talking about all of it. And if we would read the scripture, it talks about idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, revelings. I mean, you get tired just by reading the list of things that we should not be doing. But these are things that we need to meditate on, so that once we begin to mature in the spirit, in the spirit of God, once we begin to mature in the spirit, we will see that these things that would speak against in Galatians 5:17, that we will no longer have the desire to do that. But if we're not studying about these things, we're studying about financial success, and we're studying about how to get ahead in business, and we're studying about tithes and offerings, and we're studying about everything else except for these things, then it's going to be easy for us to fall into sin, because we're not even studying about that. We're not even worrying about that. We're saying that it's okay to do these things when God's word is telling us that it's not okay for us to do these things. But that comes with maturity. It comes with being spiritually minded. And one thing we have to do as a body of Christ is we need to pray that we be spiritually minded, because spiritually minded brings you life and peace. Spiritually minded is life and peace. And we need to make sure that we are living according to the word of God, not according to the word of the world, not according to the world, but according to the word. Okay, not according to the world standards, but according to the word. Granted, our former president signed into law same-sex marriages and all of that. He signed all of that into law. So now it's legal to have same-sex marriages. It's legal to do that. And I believe it's in all states it's legal to do that. But just because it's legal to do that in the world system don't mean it's legal in God's system. And we need to weigh our thoughts and be like, God, really, what are your thoughts on this? What are your thoughts on adultery, Lord? What are your thoughts on fornication? It's right here. It's right here. And remember, whatever we do, there's a penalty for what we do. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. The wages of sin is death. There is a penalty for operating in sin and living in sin and doing what we want to do when we want to do it. There is a penalty for that, and that's death. And God, it's not his will that any perish, but that we all come to repentance. So if we're married and we're sleeping with somebody who's not our spouse, and you have room to repent, you're still breathing, you have room to repent. You can come out of that right now. Don't tell yourself you can't. Don't tell yourself you can't, because you can. It's all in what you want to do. If you're in a relationship and you're fornicating and you're saying, well, I can't control my body. Yes, you can. Yes, you can, but you have to want to do that. You have to want to present your body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. When you're in there and you're thinking about these things, you're meditating on going to sleep with this person or that person. How about you change your mind and meditate on the word of God that says, I yield my body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. Good morning, Jeffrey. Good morning, Apostle Trotter. Yield your body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. But see, this is something that we have to be willing to do. God's not going to force us to live right. God's not going to force us to live holy. God's not going to force us to choose righteousness. See, the Bible, if we would go, this is why it's so important for us to study. If you would go into the book of Romans and begin to study the book of Romans, it talks about being a slave to sin, how we were formerly slaves to sin, but now we are slaves to righteousness. How that we are no longer dead in the trespasses of our sin, but how now we are dead to sin and alive unto God. And once we begin to get that understanding that I am no longer dead in the trespasses of my sin, I am no longer bound to the trespasses of my sin, but I am dead to that sin and I am alive unto God. And then we begin to see ourselves as alive unto God. And when sin comes crouching at our door, see, sin does come and it does crouch at our door and is waiting for us, but we have to be in the spirit. We have to be in the spirit of God. We have to be in spiritual things, and we have to make sure that we're doing those things that are of God. We have to make sure that we're feeding our spiritual man, not wait to go to church on Sunday. Most people don't even read their Bibles until they go to church on Sunday, and they don't even read it then. They listen to what the pastor is saying. There are people that will not pick up their Bibles or study their Bible. They will not pick up their Bibles to read their Bibles until they go to church. And sometimes they won't pick it up then because it's on the teleprompter, so they're reading it on the teleprompter. That is not feeding your spiritual man, okay? We must feed our spiritual man 7 days a week. We must make sure that we're studying our word 7 days a week. That's how we become renewed in the spirit of our minds. That's how we become dead to the trespasses of our sin. That's how we become alive unto God. But we have to renew our minds. We have to renew our minds. We have to do that. I can't wait for Apostle Trotter to do it for me. I can't wait for Jeffrey Moore to do it for me. I can't wait for my husband to do it for me. That's something that I have to do on my own. I have to pick up my Bible. I have to study my Bible. I have to meditate on my Bible. I have to do that myself. I can't depend on anybody to do that for me. I can ask them to help me in my studying, but I can't say, okay, I'm just going to wait for my husband and then I'm going to go off of what my husband knows and that's it. No, because when the thoughts of fornication come, they come to you. Okay, when the desires of fornication come, they come to you. When the thoughts of adultery come, they come to you. When the thoughts of anything that is against the spirit of God, when it comes to you. And if you stay meditating on the things of your flesh, if you stay meditating on the lust of your flesh, you're going to operate in your flesh. You're going to operate in your flesh. Anytime we say, but, I know what the word says, but I can't do that. You're making provisions for your flesh. Anytime we do that, we're making provision for our flesh. And the Bible tells us, make no provision for our flesh. Make no provision for our flesh. That's what the Bible tells us. Good morning, Sister Tammy. Make no provision for your flesh. But if we're not feeding our spiritual man, it's going to be easy for us to make provision for our flesh. It's going to be easy for us to make excuses as to why the works of the flesh are still manifest in those of us who call ourselves born again. It's going to be easy for the works of the flesh to be manifest. Why? Because that's what we're feeding, the flesh. We cannot continue to feed the flesh and expect to be spiritually minded. We cannot continue to feed our flesh and expect that we're going to mature in the Lord. We have to die daily to our flesh. Paul said, I beat my body. I beat my body under. So that if I'm preaching to everybody else, but now I'm a castaway because I didn't do nothing I preached about. I didn't study the word. I didn't present my body as a living sacrifice, holy unto God, which is my reasonable service. I didn't study to show myself approved unto God. I didn't meditate on the word day and night. Oh, now that's why it's so easy for the works of the flesh to be manifest in me, because I'm operating in my flesh. We have to come out of the flesh. We have to die to this flesh. We have to die to this flesh. And sometimes it hurts, but we got to die to this flesh. We got to die to adultery. We got to die to fornication. When that stuff comes, you say, ah, adultery, I win. I walk in newness of life. When the thoughts of fornication come, you have to say, I die daily to my flesh and I walk in the newness of life because I'm dead. In the trespasses, I'm dead to sin. Not dead in the trespasses of my sin anymore. I'm dead to that. So when sin comes crouching at your door, you can proclaim, I'm dead to that. But you can't proclaim it if you still, the works of the flesh are still manifest. We can't proclaim that we're dead to sin if we're still operating in our flesh. Some of us are making conscious decisions to let the works of the flesh continue to manifest. Some of us, we just are. Some of us have title. Some of us, we know the word of God and we're still operating in the works of our flesh. Why? Because the world is saying that it's okay for us to do that. The world is saying, oh no, just teach on love. You know, God is love and God understands that you're in your process. And you know, he really understands, Sister Teresa, that you're still in your process and that you just can't overcome that right now because it's the process. Bunk that. Get out, that, no, we're not, no, stop giving provision to the flesh. Stop making the flesh weak. Come on now. Stop giving in to the desires of the flesh and begin to operate in the Spirit of God. See, we pacify people so many times. That's why sin is so rampant in the body of Christ, because we pacify it. We make provision for the flesh. We tell people it's okay. God understands. No, God understands that when we become born again, we're supposed to be walking in the newness of life. Old things are passed away, but you have to be in Christ. You have to be in Christ. The Bible said, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. But you got to be in Christ. You got to feed your spirit, man. You got to feed your spirit, man. You can't continue to operate in the flesh and think that you're pleasing God, because the Bible says so. Then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. If we're operating, if we operating in the flesh, if we're making a conscious decision to continue to fornicate, we're operating in the flesh and we're not pleasing God. If we're making a conscious decision to operate in adultery, we are not pleasing God. We're making a conscious decision to continue to abide in the works of the flesh. We're making a conscious decision to do that. Apostle Trotter says, sin will kill you if you don't kill it. And we have to kill it. We have to kill it. Good morning, Apostle Greenleaf. We have to. That's something we have to do. We sit around and we wait for God to come from off his throne to sit down and kill our flesh. No, to kill the works of the flesh. No, we have to do that. And we have to do that by feeding the word of God, by feeding the word of God, by feeding the word of God into our spirit, man. We have to physically do this. Pick up that Bible, read that word. If you have to get tapes and let that word just feed, you know, into your spirit, get some tapes and let that word play into your spirit when you go to bed instead of the TV be on. Let the word of God go into your spirit, man, as you're sleeping. Let that word of God go into you, because whatever you feed is what's going to live. Whatever you feed is what's going to live. We can't please God in our flesh. There's two things that I know of. The Bible says that we can't, without faith, it's impossible to please God. And if we are in the flesh, we cannot please God. And it's going to take faith for us to be able to operate in the Spirit of God. But there's something that we're going to have to do. We're going to have to make a conscious decision that I no longer want to offend God by willingly operating in the works of my flesh. By willingly operating in the works of my flesh. And if we are making conscious decisions to operate in fornication and adultery and uncleanness and lasciviousness, and we're going to get to these definitions. But we know what adultery and fornication is. And if you go into study, that's why it's so important to study. If you go into study on the word of fornication, you will see that fornication oftentimes meant idolatry. Fornication oftentimes meant idolatry, so that you were out there doing other things, worshiping other things, coming against God, worshiping everything but God. That's why God didn't want his people to come into fellowship with the other nations around them, because he knew that they were going to pick up their ways and they were going to commit fornication against him. They're going to start sleeping with the enemy. They were going to start picking up the habits of the other people, and God didn't want us to do that. He didn't want his people to do that. And the same thing with today. He wants us to come out from amongst them and be separate, says the Lord. Come out from amongst them and be ye separate. Now listen, we have to live in this world because this is where we are. We're in this world, but we don't have to be of this world by the way we live. Just because the world says fornication is cool and it's all right, doesn't mean that it's all right with God. But see, we have to want to live right for God. We have to want to please God. The Bible says, so then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. So it must mean that if we're in the spirit, we're pleasing God. But we have to get there. Stop using the excuse, oh, God's not finished with me. He's still working on me. Oh, he's still working on me, honey. I can't do that right there, right now. I can't do that. Yes, you can. Because your declaration should be, I win. I walk in newness of life. I win. I walk in newness of life. Sin no longer has any authority over me because I am a new creature in Christ. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are made new. But you have to make that declaration. You have to speak that out of your mouth. Instead of saying, I can't do that. That seems a little bit too hard for me. That's not part of my process right now. Shut up. If you got to say that, don't say anything at all. Say, I win. I walk in newness. I walk in the newness of life. I win. How hard is that? I was so happy when God gave me that. I win. How hard is that to say? I win. But we make provision for the flesh and we want God to accept. That's the crazy part. We want God to accept our foolishness. We go to God as if we made God instead of he made us. We have to see ourselves in the image of God. We have to see ourselves created after his image. We have to see ourselves as we are created in the image of God. We have to see ourselves walking in the newness of life. We have to confess that we're walking in the newness of life. I'm making that declaration in my life. I am walking in the newness of life. I am no longer a fornicator. I am no longer an adulterer. I am no longer unclean. I walk in the newness of life. I walk in the newness of life. Feed your spirit, man. Die daily to your flesh. I'm crucified with Christ. I'm crucified with Christ. See, many people don't even understand what it means to be crucified. When we crucify something, it's supposed to die. When Jesus was crucified and those thieves were crucified, when they were hung up on those trees are hung up there on the cross, when they were hung up there, they were crucified. It was never an intention for them to come off those trees, off of those crosses alive. They went to on them cross with the intention to die. That was the intention, to die. When somebody got nailed to a cross, there was no intention for them to come back down. They went there to die. Jesus went to the cross to die. He was crucified for us. He died for us. But the difference between Jesus and the thieves, Jesus rose on the third day. He rose with all power in his hands for us, for you, for me, so that we could be dead to sin. That's why we must crucify our flesh. We must crucify the works of these flesh. We must nail that stuff, consider that stuff dead. But if we have pleasure in sin, we don't consider that stuff dead. If we continue to have pleasure in sin, we're not going to want to crucify it. We want to continue to live. Thank you, God, for that illustration. When he went to the cross, he went there to die. When they nailed everybody to the cross, they nailed them there to die. There was no supposed to be no resurrection of the people that went to the cross. Jesus resurrected because Jesus was God himself manifested. He rose again on the third day for us. But those other people that went to the cross, they went there to die. They weren't coming back. And he wants us to crucify. That's why he said we're crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. Crucify with Christ. Crucify that adultery. Crucify that fornication. Crucify that uncleanness. Crucify that lasciviousness. Crucify the works of the flesh. If you're walking around and the works of the flesh are manifesting you, honey, it's time to do some crucifying. It's time to start walking in the spirit. It's time to grow up spiritually. It's time. It's time to get rid of that stuff. Stop making excuses for the flesh. Stop giving way to the flesh. Stop saying, oh, God knows my heart and he's working on me. And if God wants me, this is one of the things I can't stand. If God wants me to change, he'll change me. Boo. Boo. Go somewhere with that. Go somewhere with that. You have to do something. You have to do something. You have to do something. And that's right, Sister Tammy. Some things will not go out but by prayer and fasting. Some things that you just going to have to deny the flesh. We're just going to have to deny the flesh and tell the flesh no. Tell the flesh no. Tell the flesh no. Tell the flesh no. I will not. I will not conform to this world. I will not yield my body as an instrument of unrighteousness anymore. Because I'm a new creature in Christ Jesus. I walk in the newness of life. I will not yield my members as instruments of sin. I will not open my legs to a man that is not my lawful husband. I will not. And if you're a man, you should declare, I will not get involved with any sexual activity with anyone who is not my wife. And when I say wife, I mean a real female wife. And what we need to do is we need to really go to God and be sincere. And stop going to God with excuses, expecting God to accept our excuses. Because God never said he would accept our excuses. God wants us to come to him with a pure heart. He wants us to come to him as children, humble. And say, God, you know I'm dealing with this. I'm dealing with the works of my flesh. I'm dealing with the lust of my flesh. God, I need you to help me right now. God, I need you to help me to crucify my flesh. God, I need you to help me to walk in the newness of life. God, help me as I begin to study. I don't even want to study the word, God. I don't feel like studying the word. But God, help me. Help me. See, God can deal with that. He can deal with that. But see, we have to. We have to study this word of God. That's how we get renewed in our mind. That's how we be transformed. That's how we become transformed in the renewing of our mind, by studying the word of God. We want everybody to do it for us. We want osmosis to happen. We want God to come down from heaven and do it. He did everything that he was supposed to do. He said, God, he loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes on him should not perish. But many of us are perishing for lack of knowledge. Many of us are perishing because we refuse to study and meditate on the word of God. Many of us are perishing because we just don't want to do what's right. And we want to continue to make provision for our flesh. But in the name of Jesus, I'm asking you to come out of that flesh. Come out of your flesh and begin to walk in the spirit of God. Come out of your flesh. Crucify the flesh. Crucify the works of your flesh. Crucify the works of your flesh. Bible says, I'm crucified with Christ. When Jesus rose up, when he got up in newness of life. And we're supposed to be crucified with him, buried with him, risen with new life. Somebody said, oh, I'll get my new life when I get to heaven. Not if you continue to live in sin. Not if you continue to operate in the works of the flesh, but if you go down and read what the word says, it says in verse 21, Paul says, of the which I tell you before, as I've told you in time past. So he said, this is not the first time I'm telling you this. That they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Shall not. So I don't care how much provision you make for your flesh and still say, oh, God is love and he's going to let me in. Shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Underline that in your Bible. Shall not. And if you go in Romans, you read the book of Romans chapter 1, and it talks about, you know, men doing the things with men that they're not supposed to be doing, and women doing the things with the women they're not supposed to be doing. But then if you go down and read it, it says, not only do you do these things, but you take pleasure in them that do it. So if we co-signing with people that are doing these things, we're just as bad. If we're co-signing with people that are committing fornication, I mean on a daily basis, on a regular basis, this is just what they do. Adultery, this is just what they do. And we're co-signing and we're patting them on the back. Oh, God understands. Drunkenness, God understands. You know, we don't give them, you don't go to them spiritually and say, listen, this is what the word of God says. You're no longer dead in the trespasses of your sin, but now you are dead to sin. You're dead to that. Dead to that. See, we need spiritual people in our lives that are not going to pat us on the back, but are going to tell us the truth of what God's word says. That's going to help us to walk in the spirit and not in the flesh. We should not be pacifying people and continue to say, oh, honey, God is working on you. That's just your process. And, you know, some people been in their process for 10 years. Some people been in their process for 5 years. Some people are still in the same spot they were in when they first made the confession of faith. We have to make sure that we understand that we cannot be in Christ and still operating in the works of our flesh. Something has to give. One is going to win. The flesh lusts against the spirit and the spirit against the flesh. Whatever you feed is going to win. And if we keep making excuses for the works of our flesh, we're going to continue to operate in our flesh. And the flesh, the works of the flesh are going to continue to be manifest. I'm going to tell you this. I remember one time in my life, I was shacking up with somebody. I was shacking up with this man. And let me tell you how dumb I was. Let me tell you how I was blinded by the god of this world. Let me tell you how I was blinded by the lust of my own flesh. How I was blinded by doing what I wanted to do. I lived right around the corner from the church I was going to. And I thought that if I was the last person to leave the church whenever we had service, nobody was going to know that I was shacking up. Nobody was going to know that I was living with this dude right around the corner from the church. I was shacking up around the corner from the church. And I thought that if I wait till everybody leave, you know, I'd be the last person there. And I lock up the doors and everything. It was going to be all gravy. Nobody was going to know that I was shacking up with this man. See, this is how the enemy tricks us. This is what the works of the flesh do. They trick you into believing that what you're doing, you know, it's okay. Or they'll understand. Or nobody's going to know I'm doing that. But it says the work of the flesh are manifest. That means it's being seen. It's not hidden. It's being seen. The works of the flesh are manifest. They're being seen. There's not. Nope. The cover's pulled off, honey. We see it. I thought I was, when I was shacking and dipping and tipping and all of that stuff, I didn't think nobody knew it because I was dead in the trespasses of my sin. And I thought, oh, nobody knows what I'm doing. When I found out about it, I felt so stupid. I was like, they knew I was shacking up. They knew I was shaking up. But nobody said nothing until it was months down the line. But you knew I was shaking, but you ain't say nothing. But it's not their fault. It was my fault because I was shaking willingly. I was living in sin willingly. I was going to church every Sunday. I was there every Wednesday. I was at prayer meeting at 6 o'clock in the morning every day. But I wasn't listening. I wasn't praying right. I wasn't asking God to help me to die to my flesh. I wasn't asking God none of that. I was just there performing what they wanted me to perform. Be in prayer at 6 o'clock. Be in Bible study at 7 o'clock. Be in prayer on Friday nights. Be there. I was there. Most of the time when I was in prayer on Friday night, I was going to the store, getting candy, food, you know, Chinese food. We sitting there eating. We were doing more eating and gossiping instead of praying. But see, we think that What we doing? We hiding? Nope, the works of the flesh are manifest. And if we're operating in the flesh, it's manifest. We think we hiding. We think we getting away with stuff. But we're not. It's time for us to grow up spiritually. It's time for us to meditate on the word of God. It's time for us to come up spiritually and walk in the spirit. Feed our spirit man. So that we can grow up in the spirit. So that we can please God. Because the Bible says, so then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. If we're operating in Galatians 5, verses 19 to 21, this is the work of the flesh. And if we're operating in the flesh, so then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. Repent right now. Repent right now. Repent right now. God is knocking at the door of your heart. Maybe you're not in fornication. Maybe you're not in adultery. Maybe you're not. Maybe you're dealing with envyings and murders and drunkenness, wrath, strife, emulations. We're going to get to these definitions. And the Holy Spirit will help us, but we have to submit to the Holy Spirit and stop making excuses for our flesh. Stop making provisions for our flesh. We have to stop making provision for our flesh. But as long as we operate in the flesh and we're not studying the word of God, we're not seeking the things of God, we're not fasting, we're not praying, but we're doing everything else, there will be no change. There will be no change. Seek the Lord with your whole heart. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his ways and the unrighteous man his thoughts. That's all I have right now. I'm going to say like Paul said, I beseech you, brethren, that by the mercies of God, that you present your body a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. If you want to walk in the newness of life, right now, right here, wherever you are, you could be in your bed, you could be in your car, you could be in your kitchen, wherever you are right now, just repent. God, I repent. I've been walking in my flesh. I've been operating in my flesh. But now I'm ready to stop. I'm ready to yield my body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto you, God, which is your reasonable service. It's my reasonable service. I'm ready, Lord God. I'm ready to be transformed by the renewing of my mind. I'm ready to walk in the spirit so that I don't fulfill the lust of my flesh. I'm ready to walk in the newness of life. I'm ready to be dead to sin and alive unto you, God. I'm done with making excuses for my sin. I'm done with it. I'm done with it right now, God. I'm done. I yield myself to you. And I'm a new creature in Christ. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things are made new. And if you did that, if you did something similar to that, God bless you. If you need scripture help, God bless you. I will just inbox me. I will give them to you. Inbox me. Go to my page, Teresa. Well, you're already on my page, Teresa Jeanette Scott, and I will give you scripture. If you want to get in touch with me, contact me in my inbox, and we can meditate on the Word of God together. We can do this. But it's not God's will that any of us perish, but that we all come to repentance. And if you come to repentance right now, that's a good thing. Don't wait. Don't wait to get the opinions from your friends. Don't wait to get the opinions from your family. Don't wait to get the opinions from the world. The only thing that matters is the word. Take that L out of world and go and be in the word. Because that's what matters. At the end, when we stand before God, he's going to ask you what you did. He's not going to say, well, it's okay that your friend told you to remain in sin so you can come on in anyway. Mm-mm. Nope. Come on. Come on. It's time to come in. It's time to come in. It's time to just come in and walk in the newness of life. Amen. God bless you. Y'all pray for me. This is a hard word. This is a hard word. And we just all need to make sure that we're walking in newness of life. And whatever we're doing that is not of God, we know. Because God gives us a conscience. We know when we're doing right and when we're doing wrong. We know. But we make excuses for our flesh. Time out for the excuses. Time out for making provision for the flesh. Time out for walking in the flesh, operating in the flesh. Time out. When sin come crouching at your door, tell them, nope, I win. I walk in newness. I win. I walk in newness. I win. I walk in newness. Sometimes you have to scream it. Sometimes you have to shout. Sometimes you just have to do it. I win. I walk in newness. I win. So if you win today, I'm happy for you. I'm happy that we win. We win. We're helpers one to another. Am I my brother's keeper? Yes. Yes. But we can walk away today in the newness of life, and we can walk away today and say, I win. I declare today that I win. I declare today that I win. Amen. And I declare that you win today in Jesus' name. Thanks for joining in. We'll see you again next time. Just stay tuned to my page. I'll let you know when we're coming back on. But declare today, I win. I walk in newness of life. God bless you. It's Prophetess Teresa Scott signing off for today. God bless you, and we'll talk to you again soon.